The November-December 2022 UPTEB results released today at the Office of the Prime Minister indicates that a total of 72,247 students registered for UPTEB, 66,954, that is 92%, sat for the exams, while 5,293, 7.3%, missed. These were registered in 600 UPTEB centers across the country. According to the UPTEB Executive Director Onesmus Oyesije, the year 2022 saw a great improvement in female enrollment for vocational studies. However, Oyesije points out challenges faced by the board.
Regarding annual program examinations, registered female candidates increased from 4,732 in 2020 to 12,037 candidates in 2022. The increase in number of candidates is attributed to continued advocacy for technical vocational education and training skills, introduced system of moderated assessment, the awakening of citizens towards the vocational skills acquisition, and change in admissions criteria, which was implemented by the Department of Vetcom. And this prioritizes the desire of the applicant to pursue the course of interest rather than the grades obtained at lower levels of education.
But to witness the continued growth of numbers of candidates being examined by the board over the years. As a ministry, we are privileged to continue spearheading the implementation of the TVET reforms as stipulated in the TVET policy of 2019.
State Minister for Higher Education John Chrysostom Muyingo represented the Education Minister Janet Museveni. In her message, she urged employers in the country to offer internship and training opportunities for vocational students to enable them to obtain hands-on skills.
The demand for the 21st century skills calls for the innovativeness and the research for the delivery of qualitative aid that contributes towards the production of competent technicians and artisans for social and economic transformation.
Muyingo highlighted plans to merge the Directorate of Industrial Training, DIT, and UPTEB to improve their efficiency.
This is not news to you. For instance, the Directorate of Industrial Training will merge with the Uganda Business and Technical Examination Board, and the public will be informed or updated on the progress during appropriate time. Hence, I would like to see UPTEB and DIT working together.
Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.